there with us, without whose presence every program is incomplete. So welcome, ma'am. And I would also like to welcome Dr. Panchali Mojumdar, IQSE, East Calcutta Girls College. Of course, our eminent guests and speakers of the second day, Mrs. Shanchita Roy, Vice President, Business Intelligence, Omnicom Media Group India. It's a pleasure to have you with us, ma'am. Thank you for giving your precious time to us. And of course, it goes without saying, another participant and I think a very proactive speaker who was there with us the entire day, on the very first day, Dr. Shubhadeep Chakraborty. A warm welcome to him. And without whose presence this webinar, of course, would not be a success, the participants. I welcome all the participants who have patiently stayed with us and who are going to be there with us for the next few days. So on that positive note, I would now like to invite our principal madam, Dr. Shukla Hajra, to please come and say a few words. Madam basically is the foundation of success of all the activities which take place in our college. And she is the guide who guides us through troubled waters. So we are indeed blessed to have you with us, ma'am. Thank you very much. I would like to invite you to address the audience.
Thank you, Monisha. Good morning. Good morning, everybody. I welcome Dr. Shubhadeep Chakraborty, who delivered lecture yesterday, and also again he will deliver lecture on latex today also. And also I welcome Mrs. Shanchita Roy, Vice President Business Intelligence Group India, and also all participants who joined this webinar. Actually, our teachers are very enthusiastic, they are very hardworking, and they try to first contact their students and complete their syllabus online. And now they are trying to improve themselves, and they spread these chances to others also. And they contacted many good resource persons. So I must say, we can do a SWOT analysis, means strength, weakness, opportunities, and threat of COVID-19. Actually, after COVID-19, we are using so much online teaching learning processes. Our teachers and others, they know something about online teaching, but now they are expert on online teaching and learning and arranging webinar. And also it is good for us that they contact many good resource person in other parts of India and also overseas. So we can get contact good resource person from all over the world, and we enable ourselves and our students, teachers, research scholar to get good training, and after especially on open source software, which are very useful for the future students and research scholars, because when they are going for buying any software, it costs more than 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, etc. So this will help them to do a lot. Not only that, I have seen, I don't know whether it is right or wrong, I have seen that Amazon is planning to hire 1 lakh employees who are very good or very well equipped in these different types of online jobs. So we must say that we are giving, or we are getting the chances for this type of webinar in this COVID period. This is the this is the opportunity of the COVID period, because we know the threat of COVID. We know the threat of COVID-19, and that is that's why we are taking some precautions. We are confined ourselves. We confined our students in the home, and that is and we are, in this way we are combating the threat of COVID-19. But we have some weakness on online teaching and online webinar and all that. Now we get strength of that. And we not only that, I must say about our personal life also. Sometimes, many times we are busy with the birthday party, marriage party, weekend party with our friends and all that. But nowadays, I think that many of our teachers or members or students or anyone and everyone, they are in the home and with their family members. They take the tea with their family members in the evening. And also, I must mention that in English, Professor Niladri Chatterjee, he mentioned that it is a pleasure that I am giving my lecture sitting in my study room within my family. So this is also very important that we contact those persons who are in the room and they are giving and they are enjoying their family members also along with their enjoying their teaching. So, and also I must mention, there are some innovative practice. Now I am astonished to seeing that our teacher, they are doing different types of innovative practice. They are doing different types of activities when they, what they are thinking only when they are confined in the room during COVID period. So they try to get their grievances of the students. They try to get to help the students. They try to extend their help to the affected people during coronavirus and Amphan. So they are doing a lot in their home to their students, to their friends, to the other affected people. So this is the actual gain of COVID-19, I must say. That now we are challenging the threat of COVID-19. We have strength enough. We overcome the weakness, and in future we will do in this way with our students and teachers. So this type of webinar, especially on web, especially on open source software, will help us a lot. Who are taking this? The resource person who are taking this pain to deliver lectures, I must congratulate, I must welcome, and I must give them regards to on behalf of me and my college. And I wish every success of this type of webinar which are doing by our colleagues, teachers, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for your encouraging words. I mean, really, it was a very interesting aspect. You talked about the SWOT analysis. I think that is required now. We need to know our strengths, the threat that we are facing, and the opportunities that will be gained by the webinars that are being conducted. Yes. So, thank you once again, ma'am. Without your blessings, nothing would have really worked out. So you are there to constantly inspire, encourage, and give us innovative ideas. We are really thankful to have you with us all the time. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Now I would like to invite Mrs. Shonchita Roy, the first speaker of today. She's the Vice President, as already mentioned, of Business Intelligence Omnicom Media Group India. And today she's going to speak on changes in consumer sentiments in a COVID world. Well, that is a very interesting and relevant topic today. And I know each one of us will be listening and taking home very interesting ideas from this. Over to you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Can someone please start my video, because I think it's been stopped by the host. So I'm not being able to switch on my video.
Can you please check now, ma'am?
Yes. No, it's... Yeah, I think it's working now. 1 minute.
You're visible to us.
Can you see me?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it visible? Okay.
Yes, you're visible to us.
It's okay. So thank you. Thank you, Dr. Shukla Hazra, for inviting me to address this gathering today. Thank you to Dr. Panchali Mojumdar and to Dr. Monisha Sharkar for inviting. It's always a pleasure to talk to an august gathering like yours, who are responsible for shaping the future of the generations to come. So yes, it's thank you very much, for inviting me to this seminar. And before I start, a quick introduction about myself. So yes, I'm Sanchita Roy, and I head the business intelligence vertical at Omnicom in India. So which basically deals with data analytics, with communications planning and insights, and consumer research. Omnicom, I don't know if you have any idea of, the advertising industry, but we are a part of the advertising industry. We're a media agency. What we really do is, we help clients plan for their budget. So all the TV ads that you see, all the newspaper advertisements that you see, we actually tell clients, how to spend that money. So if a client has 100 rupees, we tell the client how to spend that 100 rupees. Should he put that entire money onto television, or should he put that money into a mix of television come digital? So that's the kind of planning and strategy work that we do at Omnicom. It's one of the leading media agencies globally. And in India, it's about now 12 years old in the market. And we handle a lot of blue chip accounts like Volkswagen, Hindustan Unilever, Reckitt Benckiser, Beiersdorf, which is Nivea, to name a few. And during when this whole pandemic broke, what we really did with, we partnered with YouGov, which is again an online research agency, to understand, what are the consumer sentiments? So how are consumers reacting? I mean, it's a new normal for all of us. I think when COVID, when the outbreak happened, none of us was prepared. None of us ever knew that, we would see a situation or a world like this. So yes, so it's very important, therefore, to understand, what are consumers going through? And therefore, through this research, once you know what consumers are going through, then, as an agency, we are able to plan better for our advertisers. We can actually tell them, what are the mediums to invest in? What are the things that they should be doing? So that is essentially has been the intent of the research. And without further ado, I think I'll just share my screen and take you through the findings. Yeah, just let me know if you're able to see my screen. Again, host has disabled participant screen sharing. So can you please unlock that for me? Hello?
Yeah?
Yeah, can someone allow me to share my screen?
Yeah, it's allowed.
No, it's still saying it's disabled.
But it's allow participants to share screen. Can you please check?
I just checked it, right? Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Sorry for the inconvenience.
No, it's okay. Perfectly okay. No problem at all. So just let me know once you are able to see the screen, and I'll just jump into it. Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am, we can see.
You can. Okay, so basically this research was done, as I said, to understand the impact of COVID-19 on Indian consumer sentiments. So what we did was we actually wanted to, the entire research has been bucketed into three critical areas. One is, to understand what the sentiments are of consumers. The second bucket is to understand, what is the purchase behavior? So, what are the categories that, consumers are buying into? So how are they spending their money? And of course, because this whole pandemic suddenly, put all of us in a lockdown situation, of course, most of us were holed up at our own homes. So, you know, how does the media habits of these consumers change? So essentially, it is essentially these three buckets that I'm going to talk about a little bit more in detail. And in case you have questions, please stop me, ask questions, or I'm happy to answer them at the end of the session. So whatever works for you all, I'm fine with it. So yes, when you look at these sentiments, it is a watchful Indian. So when you asked people, you know, what is it that they think about the coronavirus, 7 out of 10 Indians said that they were somewhat scared of contracting the virus. And the fear was high amongst females in the age group of 35 to 44, naturally. I mean, parents, older moms, you know, older women, everyone had that whole fear of, you know, we can contract the virus for ourselves. And, you know, when it came to taking the precautionary measures, I think all of us really, to some extent, took certain precautionary measures so that, you know, people are able to, you know, at least delay or ensure that, you know, they do not contract the virus. So almost like if you look at the graphs on the right, you'll see that when it comes to precautionary measures, there is a high level of prudence amongst consumers. And people, there was a high adherence to measures like social distancing, improving personal hygiene, wearing of masks. And this especially, you know, could be seen in citizens amongst consumers in tier one cities. Naturally, metro cities, tier one cities, big towns are always the early adopters to technology, are always early adopters to whenever it comes to, you know, adopting any kind of measure, precautionary measures. And when we went out in the market and spoke to people, this was really apparent that while 70% of Indians were scared of contracting the virus, most of them were prudent enough to take precautionary measures. And when it comes to, you know, understanding or appreciating what the government was doing, 92% felt that the government is handling the COVID-19 pandemic very fairly well. And they feel that the government should take steps to, you know, ensure that supplies of essentials are on track. Due diligence should be taken on how to quarantine people. And of course, you know, and taking strict measures against consumers or people who are violating the protocols. And while people were not in agreement with the nationwide lockdown because of the repercussion it can have on the industry, but almost 70% felt that the lockdown should continue because it was the only way to contain the pandemic. And therefore, you know, when you ask people about, you know, what are the measures that the government should take, most of them said that, you know, ensuring essential supplies are available to everyone, ensuring that quarantine, you know, anyone who has been in contact with a COVID patient, taking stricter actions against people who are violating the protocols. This should be the priority in terms of, you know, the steps that the government should take to contain the pandemic. And, you know, when you ask consumers about, you know, what is in their mind, I mean, as a human race, we always tend to be more empathetic of our fellow human beings. And, you know, when we went out and spoke to people, that is exactly what consumers told us, that, you know, survival of people who are daily wage earners, you know, how what is it that the government can do to help them? What is it that the government and as people we can do to protect them? Not only that, you know, when people were also skeptical that people who do not follow the social distancing norms will also help in spreading the disease. So these were some of the thoughts that were there in the consumer's mind. So one is survival of people who are daily. So how are they going to survive? People who are not following the social distancing norms, they are the ones who are going to aggravate spread of the disease. And you know, India, if it does not, none of the countries, it's not India, but none of the countries worldwide are equipped to handle a pandemic of this nature. So, you know, what if there is a large outbreak, what will happen? You know, and then because the economic situation is bad, you know, what will we do, you know, if we don't have enough money, if this outbreak continues for long? So these are some of the thoughts which consumers go through in their mind. But at the same time, you know, we are a hopeful lot. So, you know, people, there are 80% of Indians feel that, you know, we will emerge stronger out of this once the pandemic is over, because, you know, we've now accepted, you know, a lot many more things. The new normal is something that all of us have started living with, and citizens in metros are more hopeful about the resurgence compared to tier one cities. And you know, when you ask people what is it that they are looking forward to, you know, when we get back into a normal life, you know, people, 72% of people said that they're looking forward to going back to work. 50% says that they're looking forward to meeting friends. 39% says that they will probably still go out and eat at a restaurant. I mean, going out, eating at a restaurant, shopping in a mall are things which are people really still skeptical about. But of course, going back to work, meeting friends, connecting with people are something which really people are looking forward to, you know, once we all come out of the lockdown situation. And of course, this brings us to, you know, the second, so that was all about, you know, the consumer sentiments. Yes, there is a pandemic outbreak that has happened. Yes, it is, people are worried about their future, about what is going to happen. But at the same time, it is a hopeful Indian. We are hopeful. We are hopeful that we will emerge stronger from this pandemic than ever before. At the same time, what we also see is, you know, when this whole pandemic outbreak happened, you know, there was a lot of impact on certain business verticals, especially, you know, there is an impact that we see on personal care and convenience business. So when the government announced a lockdown on 25th March this year, I think all of us were in a frenzy to go and stockpile on things. So there were certain categories where we really saw, you know, a surge in spends in certain categories, and certain categories where people were really not spending at all. So what we saw is, you know, it started impacting, you know, across categories, and people were stockpiling. Almost 40% of Indians had stockpiled essentials, so that because no one knew how long is this lockdown going to continue, and people were piling on essentials, on groceries, on sanitizers, on disinfectants. And what we see is that the younger consumers have stockpiled more essentials than their older counterparts. And when you go into each of these particular categories, what we really see is, you know, when it comes to groceries and food, toiletries, so these are the categories where people were really, you know, stockpiling on. So majority of the Indians were spending more on groceries and food. So the way to read the chart is all these graphs is, you know, so when you see the bar on the bar graph, so 48% at an all India level, 48% of your of consumers were spending more on groceries and food, 28% spent less on groceries and food, 23% was doing the regular, whatever they used to buy, they were not actually going and buying extra. And 2%, you know, they it's like don't know, can't say. They were not bothered about life. It was life as usual for them. But if you see, almost close to 50% of your audiences were stockpiling. So groceries and food, toiletries, which includes personal care products like soap, shampoos, those were the categories where people were stockpiling on. And what we really see is, you know, the pandemic, you know, when it really broke, when the outbreak, while some categories really saw a spike in spending, especially categories like disinfectants, hand sanitizers, but there are categories that really saw a dip in spends, which is, you know, ordering food online. This whole paranoia or this whole skepticism about, you know, you don't know who's going to deliver your food, you don't know how it is going to get cooked. So what we really see is a drop in ordering food online. So, you know, it's only 54% spent less on, you know, ordering food online. And of course, the other category where we see that consumers were spending less was personal grooming. Now, you're not stepping out, you don't have to go to office, you don't have to go to college, you don't have to go to school, you don't have to, so there was no need to, you know, invest into personal grooming, because people were saving the money that they could, because no one knows that, you know, how long this is going to continue and what the future has in store. So with the entire nation under lockdown, consumer segments, they reduced spending on consumer personal grooming products. like lipsticks, makeups, because we were not stepping out, skincare. So these categories really saw a drop in spending. And what we also saw a drop in spending is, specialty and consumer durables. So these consumer durables, so again, you were not stepping out. So where is the need? And malls and everything were shut down. So this whole thing of buying personal apparel, whether it's dresses or shoes, that saw a dip. Electronic gadgets, it did not see a dip, but what it did was people were postponing the purchases. Today, if I have to buy a microwave, I do not need it right now. I'll wait for another 6 months. Or if someone is planning to buy a car, what consumers did was actually, postponed those kind of purchases. So nearly 60% of Indians were in market for personal apparels, which includes clothes, shoes, personal accessories, and a majority of them intended to buy electronics, and approximately 1 out of 4 Indians were looking to buy into the automobile category, but everyone had actually kind of started postponing these purchases. So what we see is, high proportion of potential car buyers have postponed buying plans by more than 6 months. So whenever it's a high investment category where it was not a daily essential, you've kind of tended to, postpone purchase of that category. Similarly, we saw a similar impact even on two-wheelers. So what we see is if it's consumers during this period was only spending on essential items, which was grocery, food, personal care items, anything which did not, which really was not necessary at that point in time was getting pushed for a later date. And what we've also seen is, when you look at the auto industry, after almost zero sales in April 2020, auto manufacturers started partial production in May 20. And they've actually come up with a lot more CSR initiatives, to actually help fight the pandemic in India. So even advertisers and marketers are also doing their bit. So I'm sure all of you would have read news. So when the initial days of, when the pandemic broke, outbreak happened, whether it was Diageo, whether it was L'Oreal India, whether it was Berger Paints, whether it was ITC, everyone was making sanitizers, everyone was making mask and PPE kits and distributing it to the frontline workers. So in their own way, corporate India really came out to help fight the pandemic along with the government. And what we also see is, this whole anything which is, as I mentioned earlier, anything which is a high value purchase was being pushed or relegated to the next 6 months. So whether it was even in case of home appliances and electronics, we see the same trend. That if someone had a purchase in mind, they were pushing it for the next 6 months. So and when it comes to consumer durables, it's the same thing. 1 minute. Yeah. So that brings us to the second section of the research that we did, which was more to understand the categories we were spending it. So at Omnicom, we actually have a mix of FMCG and auto clients. So therefore, it was most important for us to understand, within FMCG, which are the categories which are really important and where clients could spend. And also, the categories where it would not be prudent for clients to spend. So, basis this, we could advise our clients to spend their money wisely. And any questions so far? Hello.
Yeah, please continue.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that brings us to the next, to the last and final section of the research that we had done, which is to understand, the evolving media consumption. The COVID pandemic, what it really put all of us as humans is, in a very unnatural situation, something that, none of us has ever, seen earlier. And I think the initial days was more about coming to terms with it and grappling this whole thing. We've never done work from home, but today, you know, as the principal madam rightly said, we all are so conversant with technology. Today we can take online classes, we can do meetings, we can do everything virtually. I mean, everything has changed. So while the pandemic has its own share of ups and downs, it has, to us, it has really taught us a lot of things. And, you know, when you look at, when you talk to consumers, when you try to understand, you know, how they are spending their time, you also see a huge shift in the way the media consumption has happened. So the first thing that we asked people is, you know, because people are stuck at home, you know, what is it that they are doing? What is it that they are doing to keep themselves busy? So I think 3 out of 4 Indians, so almost 75% of the people, are spending more time doing household activities and household chores. And what we see is there is this huge spurt in, you know, time spent on social media, on watching TV. So when you ask people on, you know, what are the key activities that they are engaging with, what they really told us was, you know, 76% are spending more on social activities. 67% of our audience at an All India level are spending more time on social media. 64% watching more TV. 57% reconnecting with friends. 52% listening to more music. And we also have a huge amount of people who's also sleeping more. So yes, you know, it, people were doing multiple things to, you know, keep themselves engaged. And, you know, if you see the social media posts, if you see the Instagram posts, you all the latent hidden talents that people had were coming to the forefront. So you see people indulging in, you know, trying out new dishes. You see people getting into, you know, a long forgotten hobby. So people were doing different things to, you know, cope with this unusual situation. Not only that, they were trying to, you know, keep themselves engaged, be happy with, you know, with the current situation that, you know, has been thrown on them. And so, you know, when it comes to, you know, understanding what are the media, how is the media consumption changing, what we really see that people are spending more time watching TV, because the whole day is, so at my home, I mean, I see my husband, you know, getting in the morning, watching the news on TV. So, you know, earlier, the morning was never a prime time, you know, in our language. But now with people being at home, everyone has started watching TV, wanting to understand, you know, what is happening, what are the steps that the government is taking. So we really see a spurt in TV viewership. Not only that, you know, there is this whole, the fact that people were watching TV and Doordarshan got back all the classics that, you know, we have grown up watching, you know, is testimony to the fact that, you know, people were spending more time, you know, on the entertainment genre. So what we see is, you know, time spent watching TV has gone up. It's almost 4 hours, 16 minutes. So it's almost a 13% increase in time spent watching TV. So the numbers that you see at the bottom of this chart is basically a research that has been conducted by BART, which is the Broadcast Audience Research Council for India. So all the TV, it's a government body that actually measures TV ratings. And this research has been done in partnership with Nielsen, which is, again, one of the leading research agencies worldwide. So when we look at, you know, people are spending more time on TV, and when you look at, you know, what are the genres where people are spending more time, so it sees that, you know, your GECs, which is your general entertainment channel, so all your Star Plus, your Z, your Colors of the World, so that has seen a 44% increase in channel share. There's a 26% increase in movie channels, 15% increase in viewership on news channels, and 8% increase in viewership of kids channels. Not only that, what we also see is even advertisers have started spending more, especially essential products. So we saw a spurt in advertising by Reckitt Benckiser because of Dettol, because of because of Lysol, because of Harpic. We saw a spurt in advertising by Savlon, by ITC. So companies which has products that were relevant to the consumers during this period, we've seen those advertisers increasing their spends on TV. And when you look at it, when it comes to time spent, so 82% of time spent on movies and 57%. So even OTT platforms, I mean, a lot of us during this pandemic has actually shifted our viewership or tried to get our daily dose of entertainment from the OTT platforms. So Netflix actually got some 15.8 million subscribers post-March, and majority of them has come from the Asia-Pacific region. Whether it's Amazon Prime, they added almost 25% paid subscriptions. So most of the OTT players, whether it's Amazon, whether Amazon Prime, whether it's Netflix, whether it's something which is homegrown like a Hotstar or even a Voot or a Sony Live, everyone has added to their paid subscription base, which means OTT consumption has been on the rise. So almost 56% of our audiences across India has been spending more time on the OTT platforms. And what are they watching on the OTT platforms? It's essentially movies and originals. So 82% of them are spending time watching movies on OTT platforms. 57% of them are spending time watching originals on OTT platforms. And both these put together is what has driven the growth for OTT in India. And what we also see is this huge spent or huge times that is being spent on social networking, because that's your way to connect. Today, you have so many apps that has come up in the last couple of months. So right from House Party to Zoom to Microsoft Teams, applications on our phone today. Because today, all of us are now virtually connected to our friends, to our families, to our relatives. So what we've seen is there is this huge time that is being spent on the social media, whether it's Facebook or whether it's Instagram. And the search that we see is primarily driven by the smartphone penetration. Low data cost, accessible smartphone penetration in India has actually led to this whole revolution of internet penetration in the country. And especially during the lockdown, we've seen almost 3 hours, 50 minutes is spent per day on the smartphone, which is almost 14% increase as compared to a pre-COVID time. And 80% of that time is spent on chat and voice messages. So which is almost a 15% increase on time spent on social networking. And of course, gaming has also become a huge, huge way to keep people engaged. So we see that, at an All India level, almost 55% of our audiences says that they're spending more time on Facebook, 38% says that they are spending more time on Instagram, and almost 70% is spending more time on YouTube. So yes, social networking and digital has actually helped people in, keeping themselves engaged during this outbreak period. And not only that, what we also see is this whole change, shift to radio and music. So music streaming apps like a Savan or a Gaana or a Spotify, we also see that, even they have seen, consumers are spending more time on music streaming apps or, playing music. So to drive away all the quarantine blues that, people are going through. We also see, a lot of time that is being spent on radio. But when it comes to radio, it is still largely a phenomena of older audiences. The younger audiences are more into music streaming apps, into streaming music online. So whether it's Apple Music, whether it's Gaana, whether it's Savan, whether it's the MX player, or whether it's Spotify. But the older audiences or the older consumers continues to, still listen to radio, still listen to those to those still listen to those age old songs or those time bands that, you know, really plays those retro kind of music. So we've seen that shift also happening. And so that brings us to the third section that, you know, we covered, which is to understand how consumer shifts has happened. So, you know, when we advised our clients, a lot of the money, we told them that, you know, it is prudent to say spend money on news channels. It is prudent to say spend money on OTT platforms and not so much on the GCs, because this is also during the lockdown period, none of the Hindi entertainment channels had original content. And that is why we see this shift happening on OTT platforms, because that is newer content that, you know, consumers had access to. And therefore, you know, we could advise our clients to spend their money wisely. So that brings us to the last section. You know, when you see the world, I mean, it's a new normal for all of us, you know, and how have brands coped with it? So, you know, brands are also trying to adapt to the new normal. And the key thing, or the most important thing that, you know, one should remember here, that, you know, today, if you have to succeed today as a brand, if you want to be in the consumer's consideration set, or if you want to be the consumer's most preferred brand, you also need to adapt to the new normal. You also need to understand, you know, where the consumer shifts are happening. You also need to understand, you also need to understand and be empathetic towards consumer requirements. So what we've seen is, you know, we've tried to see, you know, what are the things. So how can brands succeed, you know, in a time like this when everything around you is changing? So one is, you know, educate consumers with the right information, say the right message. And you know, case in point being Reckitt Kaiser, their whole hashtag disinfect to protect, you know, was aimed at telling or educating consumers how consumers on why it is so important to keep surfaces clean and disinfect surface so as to help break the chain of infection. So educating with the right information is point number one. It's one of the most critical things that brand should do during times like this. The second thing is, you know, be a corporate, from a corporate image, become a human, be human, be empathetic, understand what consumers are going through, understand the shifts that is happening and how consumers are trying to change to it. Because only when you come across as a human brand, only then will consumers take to you. So you, Hindustan Unilever, the largest advertiser in the country, in collaboration with UNICEF, they launched a campaign called hashtag break the chain. So which talked about three key things: social distancing, hand washing, and generosity. So it actually tells you that, you know, as a brand, you know, this is a brand that cares for me. This is a brand that is thinking about me, that has me at their center. It's not about, you know, the brand is not out there to make money. The brand is out there to think about me and do things that will benefit me in the long run. You know, being genuine and empathetic, you know, brands need to do that. And that is, you know, Ariel's most successful campaign of sharing the load. It's a situation when all of us were locked down. I think the situation demanded that everyone in the house came to share the load of the household chores and not leave it to only the women folk. The man and the women had equal responsibility to share the household chores. And that's what Ariel's campaign spoke about, you know, when they came with hashtag share the load campaign. The second is, you know, keeping consumers engaged, because if you are not engaging with your consumers, your brand will never be top of mind. So Nivea's, the latest campaign which they launched during the lockdown period is all about hashtag many ways to care. So it's a digital first campaign saying, you know, asking people to, you know, what are the different ways in which they could stay at home and still have fun with their kids. So, you know, you ask consumers to share their fun moments, how they are engaging, their ideas of how they are engaging or spending time with their kids. And it was a campaign that was really successful and really went viral. Of course, you know, what times like this also needs is, you know, to be agile, to be able to keep up with times. So, you know, today, when you see the pandemic breaking out, I think, you know, a lot of advertisers, you know, what it required was agility in media planning. People were watching news. People were not watching Hindi entertainment channels because it didn't have new content. So, you know, being agile enough to change your media plan, being agile enough to change your strategy, that is something that, you know, that was the need of the hour. And people and brands which have been able to deliver on that has been able to strike a chord. And it's also, you know, the other thing that we've seen, almost all big advertisers, everyone came up with this whole message of solidarity, of, you know, standing by people, standing by the government during these trying times. So, you know, being agile, being able to adapt to changing times is something which is very critical. And brands who are able to travel that journey will always be successful. And finally, you know, influencers and your social media strategy. Today, it is not about, I mean, today you have people are posting on their Instagram. So influencers are no longer limited to Bollywood today. You have homegrown influencers, you have macro influencers who could be the girl next door. So, you know, how can we use influencers? How can we use them in a better way so that they are able to, you know, put forward the message of social distancing? How can they put forward the message of using hand washing, of using sanitizers? You know, so using influencers is a very critical pillar, you know, in a marketing strategy. And Reebok did that, you know, with home workout videos. People were at home, there were no exercise. So Reebok really cashed in on this situation and they did home workout videos with Katrina Kaif then you had Dettol's hand wash challenge. You had Ritesh Deshmukh and Philip, you know, coming together to do this whole trimming at home because your salons were open, people couldn't go out for a haircut. So, you know, understanding the consumer needs, identifying the influencer, and then getting the influencer to influence consumer behavior is, if brands are able to latch onto that, to activate that, that is, again, one of the big ways in which brands could still stay relevant within their consumer set. So that brings me to the end of the section. And this is about, I've spoken about Omnicom and I've spoken about YouGov. And so this research, a little bit more on the research. So it's basically, you know, it's a pre-designed question that was administered, you know, using OMG Connect, which is our collab online panel in collaboration with YouGov that we have. We conducted the research in 10 markets, which is a mix of metros and tier one cities. And we had a sample size of 30 spread across this research centers. And we spoke to 25 plus male and female audiences, you know, salaried businessmen, housewives, so that we get a sense on, you know, what the consumer sentiments are. So yes, that brings me to the end of the session. Any questions, I'll be happy to take them. Yeah.
Thank you, Shanchita. Just one moment. Monisha will be with us shortly. Just one moment. So there is a question by Ms. Ruchika Gupta in the chat box, if you can see it.
Yeah. That So this is an online panel. So what we do is we've said it is 25 plus male and female. NCCS AB, which is NCCS is basically it's a socio-economic classification factor, and we had reached out to those certain markets. So basically, when you say it is 92% of Indians, it is within the 300 set of audiences that we are researching. We use that number and then extrapolate it to get a sense on, you know, what is it that majority of consumers in the markets are saying. Explain the ways evolving media consumption during COVID is or will impact the younger. See, it is the way the outbreak has actually impacted younger audiences. So A is it is people are holed up. So this whole OTT, this whole social networking, and this whole increase in time spent on digital, on OTT platforms, is mostly led by, if you see the graphs, is mostly led by the younger audiences. So it has started its impact. I mean, it's not that it is going to impact. We are in a situation where we've seen these, and these are current. These are, I think this, the report was done in the first week of April. So which is immediately after the outbreak, the pandemic outbreak happened, we actually went out in the market to understand. So this is as recent as last month, and yeah, so it is, it has already impacted, and going forward, it is going to have deeper impacts in the way consumers consume media. Any other questions?
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. It was really very interesting and a very well-researched topic that you presented today. And I mean, the way you completely took us on a journey, changing consumer choices that are taking place, and the consumer behavior which is changing because of the pandemic. So how we are now more interested in the essentials rather than our frivolous choices which were there earlier. And then the interests which are more now related to the social media, to the virtual world, and of course how our priorities are changing. You have made it very clear and very comprehensive. I mean, it was really very, very interesting to see the trajectory of the change which is taking place in our society. So we really enjoyed your talk, madam. And of course, very important, the aspect which you talked about at the end, when you mentioned that how we are to adapt ourselves to the new normal, and how the influences can be of macro as well as micro level. That is what is very interesting. So thank you very much. And I think there are participants who have listened avidly to your lecture and would now like to question you on your presentation. So over to Shemunti. Shemunti, can you please take up the question?
Yeah, I'm more than happy if people have questions. You know, you can always write to me at my personal ID, or, you know, and I'm more than happy to answer and connect with people and, you know, answer any queries that they might have.
Monishati, we have already...
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. I mean, we really enjoyed the talk. It was quite a refreshing change. So now I would request Shivanti to please take up the questions.
Monisha, we have already taken up the questions. Monisha, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, we have already taken up the questions.
Yeah. So if no one has any questions, then So yeah, I'll just end the session. And thank you so much once again for inviting me, you know, to talk to this gathering. As I mentioned earlier, it's always a pleasure to talk to you, people like you, you know, who are responsible for shaping the future of our country. And so thank you for whatever you guys do. And yeah, it's been a pleasure interacting and knowing you all. Yeah.
Yeah, Monisha Di.
So if there's nothing, should I just log off?
Thank you, Shanchita Di. We were very glad to have you with us. So Monisha Di, you there? Monisha Di?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so we have already addressed the question answer session.
Okay. Thank you.
So thank you everyone once again.
Yes, and it was really a pleasure and a privilege to have you with us. Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
So we now take a short break, and I think it is very interesting that most of the participants have requested to not prolong the interval. That tells about the involvement and the interest which this webinar has generated. So, going with the tide, we will call a very short break of 5 minutes. And then we will ask all the participants to come back once more so that we have Dr. Shubhadeep Chakraborty with us. And I hope that 5 minutes is enough, because according to the popular demand, it was the resource person who was supposed to be given more time. That tells us that the webinar is already a success, and I would like to congratulate you, Avanti.
The first one is, yeah, it is unknown to you, most people. So it is saying internet connection is unstable. I may change the internet connection. Please hold on. Can you hear me? Please respond.
Yeah, Shubhadeep, we can hear you.
Oh, okay. Let me continue.
I have changed. We can hear you, and your screen is also perfectly visible to us.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Welcome.
So, yeah, what I found is the part. Most of you could not do it, because a calligraphy part is a part of the math mode. You cannot do it using the bold font or italic type of command. You need to use, let me go to the So I want to say that I have uploaded the recent talk file in the classroom. Please download it. Hello.
Lost your screen.
Yeah, I rejoin. Can you see? You hear me now?
On screen.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yes.
We can
see.
Okay. Sorry for 1 minute. Okay. So I was, yeah, the folder name was practice. Yeah. Let me open it in my editor. I will go through all the comments one by one. The first one is the how to write the calligraphic font. So yes, it is a Okay, let me copy the packages. All right, now we need. Yeah. So I hope you, most of you have done. I am commenting, I mean, yeah, even in the comment part. So all the packages are active in my computer. So yeah, I hope you have done with the compiler problem. If not, it will take time. Just go through the slides now and try this when the problem is solved with the compiler. The best way to solve it is just uninstall the whole thing and reinstall the compiler fully. Okay, so to write the calligraphic point. So it is math mode. So you need to So I am very sorry. Can you hear me? I hope you can hear me. I am very sorry. The internet is making problem for the bad weather.
No, no, it's perfectly all right.
So, yeah. Dollar sign. Then, second bracket. And right, L for calligraphy. C-A-L. Okay. Cal. Then, space. Then, whatever you want to. Right, say your name. Why, who are your name? Okay, so let me file it. So it is done. Let me check. Yeah, you can see the last part, your name is what I have written in the phone, but you know it is in math mode, so there is no space in between. The space doesn't work in math mode. So what you need to do, just give quitting sign here to generate a space in the PDF and compile it again. Now check it. Yeah, there is a space in between your and name. Now you can make a larger font using your large anything, or and you can make it a different color using text color. Okay. So now I will go to the next thing. So in the assignment 2, there was a part called density field. Some of you have tried to write this in italic because it may look like italic, but it is not actually the italic.
Can you hear me?
Okay. So I will write now. Where I am writing? Oh, no.
Can you hear me, Shubhadeep? Shubhadeep, hello.
So I will write this. So you should write this in math mode. So you know that slash so. Excuse me.
Well, hello participants. We're sorry for the inconvenience. Actually, there is huge internet issues at the end of the speakers. So he is leaving the platform and rejoining with us. So please bear with us for some time. Thank you.
Hello.
Yeah, Shrutip, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
This time I can hear you. So, you can start now.
Yeah. So I can hear you now.
So can you please share your screen?
Yeah, I am sharing it, and I have changed the internet connection also. Actually, it is the weather is very bad here.
Okay, and that's beyond our control, unfortunately.
So I'm going to it again. So how to write something in calligraphic font? Okay, so calligraphic is a math mode, so you cannot do it in usual way like bold font or anything. So you need to put dollar sign here. So put $, and within second bracket, you just write /cal, then give a space, and write your name. Then your name will appear in calligraphic font in the PDF. But you know, within $, the ordinary blank space doesn't work. Okay, so what you have to do, wait a minute. It's in the salary, no? So what you need to do, just put a little sign, which will effectively give you a space in the PDF. Okay, so now I am going to compile it, okay, using the PDF LaTeX command, and let me check what is the output, and you can see the output is here, your name, okay, so there is a space between your and name, this is due to the video sign. But if you remove the legal sign, there will be no space. You can check it. Okay. Now the second point what I found is writing the density field and momentum field, etc. In the assignment 2. So that is written actually in math mode. So you have to write that in math mode. Within the $, so here it is /row within bracket x comma t. Okay, that will give you row x in math mode. Let me check. Here it is row x in math mode. Can you hear me? Tell me now, or anything? Any problem? Samantha? Any problem? No response from that side. So I'm stopping the share screen and going to chat. Oh, someone is writing. No, no problem. Okay, fine. Thank you. So I'm sharing the screen again. Okay. So the next point I found is writing the error function inside the equation. Okay. So earlier I told you that if you write something inside a dollar mode, some function, there are some inbuilt function, right? Like sign, cos, you need to write them with using slash command. Okay. So I will write, say, okay, why not to produce the whole equation? Right, it's in assignment, right? Assignment 2, I think. So here is the I think it looks good. Okay, so I am going to write this equation, equation 3. So please have a look. So, say slash, so, and this equation contains more than one line. So I should use equation array instead of equation. So beginning. Equation EQN array and also end equation array. Okay, now I will write the whole equation slash array to row x comma t is equal to slash sum lower limit to sum n equal to minus infinity slash I n f t y infinity.
Row zero term is missing, sir.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, thank you very much. So where is row zero? Row zero times sum over n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity, so only infinity, I n f t by infinity. Then look that the third bracket or square bracket starts here, but no third bracket is here. Okay, but you know it will give error if you don't put left slash left. If you start with slash left, you have to put slash right at the end, otherwise it will give you error. So there is a way to overcome that. And now I am going to write that slash left to get larger third bracket. Now the error function is not defined like sine or exponential, so you cannot get slash erf. Sorry, ERF. Instead, if you need to write anything which is not in italic form, inside any equation or math mode, you can write this in this way, slash MVOX, inbox. Inbox, then write whatever you want, it will not be in math mode. So ERF I will write. You can use this in sine cos, for the sine cos also, but you don't need because they have inbuilt function in LaTeX. So this is the ERF. Okay, now left bracket, so slash ABFT, immediately close slash RIGHT right. Okay, then write whatever you want inside this. Yeah, so there is a fraction slash FRAC fraction. Okay, so 2NL minus L by 2 plus X, and in the denominator, so the square root is all over 2 and t. The little t, the small t, is out of the square root. So how to write square root? It is SQRT. Okay, this second bracket is useful, or the active zone, for the square root. So whatever you write inside this will be activated under the square root. 2 times capital T. Now write small t outside the square root zone here. Now remember, you started third bracket with a left. If you don't put right something, it will give error. So there is a command called null command. So put HT, then place a dot. Okay, you can see. So here is the final thing to avoid the error due to left right. So you don't want to put third bracket at the end. So you put slash right dot, it will give nothing. Let us check. Okay, let us check the first line. PDF LaTeX is done. So it is this one. Yeah, you can see I have started with a third bracket, but there is no third bracket in the end. Okay, and the square root is for 2 and capital T, not the little t. Fine, but I have an equation number here which I don't want. So let me go to that A part again. Yeah. So to do that, just put slash no number. That will not work. Right thing will not work if you don't have the package AMSMath, the math package from American Mathematical Society, AMS. Okay. Now what I will do, I will just put a line break here and go to the next line. So the similar thing, I will not write everything here. So let me copy this to save time. Okay, let me check what I got. Yeah, I got this thing. No equation number in the first line due to the no number command, but there is an equation number for the second line. I have copied the same thing, so it appears as same thing. Now, suppose not the alignment thing I'm going to discuss, and I want to close the third bracket. So slash RIGHTRI third bracket closed. What will give me error if you don't open any left? So again use slash left dot a null command. Okay, so the null command and a third bracket, and use a plus sign, say it is, yeah. Now let me check what is the output. Here is the output, a plus sign and a third bracket. Okay, so now what you want to do, I want to align the equation. So I want to put the plus sign just below the equal sign. Okay, so that it looks good. So use AND, the both side of the equal sign, and then I should put it here. Okay, now let me check. You can see it has been shifted so that the plus sign is just below the equal sign. So this is the way to write an equation under equation array. I hope you got this. Now let me go to the other things. What is left? Okay, another thing is, so whenever you write bold font, you need to put bold font in whatever you want, write your text. It is not like the underline command. Okay, if you write slash bf, then write your text. It actually make the whole text after the bf command. It will make bold the whole text, not the selected area. So if you want to write in this way, you need to write slash bf text. Or TEXT, text bold font. This will work. Either this or this. Okay? I hope you got this. So let me compile it. Yeah. So someone asked me how to change the font style, say Times New Roman or Serif or something. So that is a detailed question, I mean advanced level question. So what you can do, there are two ways. One is, I mean frankly speaking, there is no Times New Roman particularly in LaTeX. There is another software called Zetex, X-E-T-E-X, which is specially made for the font style. The LaTeX is made by the mathematicians, so they usually take care of the equations and everything. There are many font style inbuilt, but not the Times New Roman. Okay, so this font we are using here, all over this text, this is one type of Roman font. It is called a modern computer Roman. It will take automatically. This is the default font. Okay, and if you want something else, there are two ways, one easy way and another a difficult way. So the easy way is, I have written it here. The easy way is, forget about the no intent, you know what is this. So this is Rm slash Rm is for woman, right? Hello world. And this hello world is the ordinary by default, second line. Now this is the third line is for the serif font. Sans Sans. Okay. And the third one is typewriter font. So you can see these two actually same, first and second, as Roman is the default font. You can see here is the output. This is the first one in Roman. This is the by default, it is Roman. This is the sans serif, right? Yeah, sans serif. And this is the typewriter font. Okay? This is the easy way to get a different kind of font. You can search in internet. And there is another way in LaTeX, that is to use package. So you need to package these two packages made for font. Okay. If you want, I can give you this name of these two packages, or you can copy that. And if you want, declare in the beginning the package name, then the way to use different font is using this command. So slash font family and select font, these are common for everyone. Now QCR is the code name for each font. So this is the general text you want to change the font style. So I use different code QCR, CMR, PTM for different type of font style. Okay, and they appears to be this for different type of font styles. Okay, so one of them is the modern computer Roman font. This is inbuilt. So you can see, let me show you. Okay, so here is the, you can see the font code. I used CMR, LMR. You can use so many font code to get different type of font. So for computer modern Roman, I used CMR. So for Latin modern Roman, LMR. So there are so many codes in this website. I will give it in the classroom. I will give the link. You just educate yourself. Okay. So let me go to the slides then. Okay, we ended here yesterday. So let me start from here. So more about brackets, I have discussed. Since braces or curly brackets are used in to group in LaTeX, group or marking some active region or something. So they are very useful in LaTeX. So if you want curly bracket to be printed in your PDF, so you have to use slash curly bracket. Okay, slash this and slash this. And since every left needs a matching right, it is important to have null comments left dot and right dot, which do nothing. So here is an example I already discussed. So I have used left first bracket but right dot. So it will give only the left bracket. Now there are many accent in math. Okay. So say a hat, a dot, time derivative, double time derivative, a double dot, a tilde. So this is the command for this accent. Okay, so just it's very easy. The same name slash hat, but you need to use dollar sign everywhere before and after because it is math mode. So slash hat slash dot double dot is d dot double dot tilde bar and vector. Okay. Now I will go to a new thing, that is how to include a figure in LaTeX. So you just write down these few lines to include a figure, where begin figure and end figure is even necessary. Begin center and end center is not necessary. I put it two so that the figure file, if I the figure appears at the center of the document, okay, for the centering command. And leave the mode. Right now I will suggest to follow this blindly. We have many useful words. You can just copy and search it in internet. So if you don't put it, the figure will appear, but sometimes it is useful. So it is recommended to use this command, and it is the most important thing. So include graphic, okay, slash include graphics, then width is equal to some scale 7 centimeter, comma angle equal to 0. So it will not change your aspect ratio of the original figure. If you want to change the aspect ratio, you can add a height is equal to some 5 semi. Okay, forcefully change the height also, and using a comma. Similar way, in a similar way, within this third bracket, use width is equal to 7 semi, comma height is equal to 5 semi. Okay, now you can change. I will not recommend that height part because it distorts the figure file, not the original in the LaTeX. So just use this and you will get inside what you want. And then name of the figure file, okay, the figure file name. Suppose your figure file name is some file name dot JPG. So you have to write the full thing, figure name dot JPG with the extension. If you have some EPS file, use figure name dot EPS. Okay, I will use that very soon. You can write. Now if you want to write a caption, this is not mandatory. If you want to write a caption, you need to write the caption here within the second bracket with the command caption. Okay, now this is a new thing, label. The labeling a figure slash label, write anything you want. Suppose your figure is for a distribution, so you write the number distribution. Okay, now you will call this name by this name, number distribution, when you want to use the figure in your text. Okay, like equation and figure number also will appear automatically in figure. Okay, let me check if I include a figure, how does it look. So I have included a figure, okay, and it looks like this. I have wrote this whole thing in the caption and it appeared as a caption. As I am writing it in a presentation environment, so no figure number is here, only figure. So in ordinary document, a figure number will also appear here. It will be useful if you want to refer this figure in the text. Okay, so let me check. But remember, you know, you need the packages, okay, to not the color package. I think the APS, sorry, AMS math package will be sufficient to include a figure. Okay, those who have the packages, please try this with me. I am going to include a figure in the text. Okay, so keep the figure. I have already, I mean, you can use your own figure I have uploaded a figure file in the classroom. You can download it or you can use your own figure. But remember, you need to keep the figure file in the same folder. So I am using everything in this folder, practice. So I need the figure file in practice. So I will copy this. This is my figure file, UL-HM, etc. Like extension is .eps. This is EPS PostScript type of figure file. So I am going to copy this in my working folder, practice. Okay. So I have copied it. Now I am going to include this copied and pasted that part. Begin figure center is there. I need to change it, the figure file name. So what is my figure file name? Here it is. I'll copy it and paste it here. Okay, this is a raw profile. And I need to write a caption, just keep it as it is. So I will change the label. Okay, so write a label, say distribution figure, DISTN in short, distribution, I use underscore as a name, FIG. Distribution figure, I am labeling it by this name. I will call it. Okay. So I will call it here in the text. Let me compile. Yeah. Here it is. You can see the figure has appeared in the document, and whatever I wrote in the caption section, it appeared as a caption. Okay. Now I want to write about this figure in the text. How to write? Using the label. So I am going to do that. So now I write. So here in figure / reference to refer. Okay, this is the comment to refer. I will refer. What I want to refer, I use this label. Okay, I have labeled this figure, so I will use this here. Okay, here in figure, distribution figure, we have shown, plotted the distribution of particle number in within math mode. This is not necessary. I am writing just to make it realistic. TN with again $ in. Okay, so I will compile it twice. First time it will get the information about the label, and second time it will give you the result. So what it is written? Look, Here in figure 1, we have plotted the distribution of particle number Pn with n. Okay. So now I never use this number 1 here. You can see in the text, I didn't use. I use the label name. It will automatically take the figure number. If you have, say, 10 or 20 figures, you don't need to put the figure numbers everywhere. The advantage of these things is you have a large document, and if you want to cut and paste, you say that you want to rearrange the document. Okay, the first portion will go to the at the last, some kind of thing. And then you don't need to change the figure number or reference number, anything by hand. If you put this name different for every figure, it will take automatically. The figure number will take automatically. When you refer, then also the figure number will be taken automatically. That is the advantage of LaTeX. You don't need to do anything by hand. Once you have done, you are done. Okay? So you can label your equation also. Right? So there is no number, but here is a number. Okay? So you can see, I am going to discuss about this equation, equation 9. So first line of the equation line, there is no number. So there is no meaning calling that equation. But the second line is actually the end of the equation. So I am going to call that part. Okay. So I will put a label there, like I did in figure. So slash label, give a label name, say density spread, spread. Okay, so I gave a label. Now I want this equation to refer, okay, in the text. So we present the spreading of density field row x comma t, okay, in equation, this is just for the equation name, it will appear in the text. So it is a style recommended in American Physical Society to write equation within bracket. Okay, so I give that bracket. Now I will refer in similar way, slash ref, refer within second bracket, write the label name of the equation, that is what I have done. Let me check. I think density spread is the label. D-E-N-S-I-T-Y, density underscore S-T-R-E-A-D. Let me check. Okay, so I used the label density spread. I already, yeah, here it is, density spread. I used as label of equation 9. So I never write the equation 9 here, right? The number 9 didn't appear in the text document, but it will appear. Do it twice. It will appear. Yeah, here you can see. So it presents the spreading of density field rho xt in equation 9. So similar way, we can refer everything. So what we can refer? we can refer figure, we can refer equation. Look, equation 9 is here and it is referred here. Anywhere in the main text, we can refer section also. You can see. So, I'm going to refer a section now. So, suppose we'll create a section here. Slash section, give a section name, say then density spreading, okay, give a subsection, you all know this already, say writing equation, okay. Now you put a label here, slash label, okay, give any name, say section and then city spreading, okay, give another name for this subsection also, label section. It is not necessary to give this section here, I just put it as a name. So say writing, writing equation. So I have two different labels for two different section, and I now I'm going to call them, okay, in new section. Say I have started a new section here. Section test. Okay. So let me compile first. I didn't refer till now. So you can see. So you have one section, density spreading, and then one subsection under this density spreading with different font and different number. This is Roman 1, this is A. And then you have another section here, section test. Okay. Now I'm going to refer these two sections and subsections in this section, section text. So let me refer. So copy exactly what I have, I mean you have written as a label name, otherwise it cannot recognize. And now write in section, is capital as it is the name of the section, section slash refer, give the section label, we have discussed, about density spreading. Write whatever you want. And in section, keep the label of the subsection where it is. Yeah, writing equation. I will copy this. Slash refer here, right? We discussed about writing an equation. Okay, so let me compile. Zero error, one warning, neglected. Yeah, you can see. So first level is here in figure one, etc. It is done. So here, from here. So in section one, we have discussed about density fitting. You can see this is section one. Section number one. And in section 1A, so this is the subsection, that is, it is under 1. So section 1A, we discussed about writing an equation. So I hope it is clear. So I am stopping the screen share mode and let us see any confusion or doubt is there. Any question?
Shivadip, there are a few questions in the the chat box. One is how can they write vector symbol?
Vector symbol I discussed, right? So slash break the accent. So I will show you when I share the screen. And another question is slash cal working only for capital letters. For small letter it gives output in the form of mathematical symbol. Okay, that is new to me, because you see I wrote a whole word with capital and small letters. I don't know why it is doing so in your compiler. You just try it again, or just I don't know. Frankly saying, I don't know what is the problem. Maybe the compiler dependent problem. You can just ask in Google your problem. Okay, so if no more question, I will go to the share screen mode and show how to use vector symbol using LaTeX. It is slash make A will give you A, an arrow above it. This is the vector sign. Okay, if you need anything more, you just ask Google, there is a way. Okay, I have given some examples of the accents. And so how far we have gone, how to input figures is done. So you know, if you put this in caption, it will appear in the caption. Labeling and cross-referring, where I have already discussed, label any label name and then refer slash REF. You can find it in the updated doc file in the classroom. So here is an example also. Okay. Now I will go to array. Array and table. How much time do I have, Simantidi?
So you still have, it's almost 1 hour.
1 hour. Okay. I mean 2 or 2:15, right?
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
2 to 2:15, we have to wrap up.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay, yeah, I may wrap up before that also. So array, how to write an array in LaTeX. Okay, so to construct an array, surround the entries or elements with a begin array justification. Okay, and a command, and then at the end write end array command. Okay. The justification should consist of L for left justification, C for centered justification, or R for right justification. Okay. So what is justification? You will understand in the next slide what is justification. Just now, remember that. Now here is an example of how to write an array. There is begin equation array you have to put in the beginning. Okay. And if you give no number, there will be no equation number. It will be treated as an equation. And if you want an equation number, just remove this number part. Okay. So everything will be under begin equation array and end equation array. Okay. Then I want a bracket. Okay. I want a bracket here. So this is left bracket slash left to make it large. I mean, it will take the size of the array. If you use this left command, you already know. Then the actual array begins slash begin array with a justification CCC. I have used 3C, 3 for each column. So the number of justification should be same with the number of columns. Okay. So I have used center for all, C for center. Okay. Now write array elements. Say I want to use alpha, beta, gamma. So separate them with an and. Alpha and beta and gamma. Then a line break. So alpha, beta, gamma, then a line break. If you don't put this line break and give an ordinary enter, so the next line will appear just after this. Okay? And it will give you error because of this CCC. Because you have declared that there are only three columns. So how the rest of the columns are appearing? It will give an error. So put a line break here, then delta and epsilon and zeta, delta epsilon zeta, again line break, and similarly the third line, and line break, then end array. Okay, then end the right bracket, and end equation array. This will give you this output. So what is the justification you will see here? Okay, so if you do the same thing, same formalism, just I am focusing on this line, begin array justification. So here it is. So begin array justification. So left, center, right. So left for the first column. So you can see I have written four words, red, blue, green, magenta. The left justification will make the alignment of the left side. Okay. The center justification will make the second column, each element of the second column at the center. And right justification will make, it will align the third column in such a way. Okay. You can change. This is not necessary to right, left, at left, C at center. You can write anywhere, anything, and it will change accordingly. Okay, so if you write R, L, C in the same array element, so it will give you right alignment for the first column, left alignment for the second column, and centering for the third column. Okay, so if you can notice that you have four row, so row number it doesn't matter, you can add, but the number of justification R, L, C, or if you have four columns, you should write R, L, C, C, four justification. This would match number of column and number of justification. I think it is okay. So next, I will go to the table section. Okay, I'll go to the table section. And you can see how to write a table using LaTeX. Okay. So begin center and end center is not necessary. This is to put such that it appears in the center of the document. Now begin tabular, then again justification like an arrow. Okay, if you don't put this vertical line, okay, you will not the vertical line in the table. So the first vertical line here will appear as the first vertical line in your table, the whole line. The second line will appear as second vertical line, third and fourth, according to that, third line and fourth line. Now you want the A line also, horizontal line also. So put a horizontal line. So this first H for horizontal slash H line will give you this horizontal line, the first line. Okay. Then you write the first entries. So colors and animals and subjects. Colors, animals, subjects. Then put H line. Another horizontal line will appear as the second horizontal line. Okay, then red goat sciences double slash will work as a line break and so on. So second line, third line, fourth line. Then put a horizontal line to end the table. Okay, this is the third horizontal line. Then end tabular and end center. Is it clear? So I will try playing with this thing in my test document. You can also copy from the PDF I have uploaded and play with it. Okay. So here it is. I just copy and paste in my test and take document and I will run it. Let me see what is the output. Here it is. Here it is. Okay. And I want to play with it. So if I remove, say, the second vertical line, I removed it. Now I compile. Yeah, it has been removed from that PDF. Now put a vertical line here, just above the enter. Okay. So just above the enter key in your keyboard, put a vertical line here. And remove this line, or I will not remove, I will just comment it out by using a percentage just before the line. Yeah, the second vertical line has gone. Okay, so in this way you can make and table in your LaTeX. Okay, what is next? Now what happens, one more thing, what happens if you don't put this begin center? Let me check. Let me first show you. How does it look? How to remove it? Okay. Okay. So it is at the center of your document, right? So if you don't put that centering command, begin center and end center, it is not so harmful. You can see the table came here at the left. So if you put center, it will come at the center of your document. And this centering is applicable for anything, table, figure, equation, table, anything. So I will keep the centering command. Okay, let me go to the presentation. So now table of contents. So if you want to write a large document, it is essential to write a table of contents. Suppose you are writing a thesis, so a table of content is necessary for a review article. So for that also you need a table of contents. Now, once you have used the section commands, so you already have some section name and number in your document. So LaTeX already have the information about your sections and figures and everything. So when you use just one command, this one, table of contents / table of contents after your begin document command, so it will generate automatically a table of contents, okay, in your documents. So how does it work? Let me have a look. So I have already generated one. I will show you. Okay. I think the case 6 is there. Can you see this?
Yes, we can see.
Okay. So I have changed the document class, because in RevTech 4 is specially for writing a paper in physical review journal. So the command table of contents will not give you a good result there. So I changed the document class to article. Okay. Don't worry, I will share everything, every tech file with you in the classroom. And so I use this article, but I commented out this affiliation part, as this affiliation command will not work for article class. This is specially written for the RevTech course. I commented out. So it will overlook, the compiler will overlook this line. Now, what I have made, so the rest of the thing are same, okay? So some slight change is needed for article document class. So I think you need to write this title, author, date just before the document, begin document, and you need to write the abstract after the make title commands. I think it was just take it what to change. Now I am going to write. Also, I changed this two column mode. So I used one column. Okay, I used one column and increase the font size so that different section appears in different pages. Okay, I increase the font size. So it will generate the output. Let me check what is the output. Okay. Thank you. So taste 6 is my, I will open it in my editor. Yeah. Okay. So I will generate. It is done. Okay. So test 6 has been generated. So it has been changing structure as it is different documents. So writing document in LaTeX, everything is there. There is no institute and everything abstract has been appeared in form of abstract. Then introduction and everything. You see there are many sections and subsections. Okay. So you already have this sections and subsection and assignment one. Writing equation is this. I have static structure vector. Oh, okay. Something else. And yeah, I have the figure and everything. So I have a document. Okay. With different section in different pages. I want a table of content. So I will write this command. You can see the table of contents, just one single line after the make title. So begin document, then make title, then table of contents. Okay. So what does it keep? Compile twice. You can see title, then table of contents with this extra feature content, then introduction at page number 2, different sections and subsections in different ways. We don't need to write in by hand. It will take automatically, but it looks bad. If you want to look good, we just need to write save page break / /pagebreak page break. Okay, so I'll use this page break once after the title, one after the table of content, and one after the abstract. It is already there. Okay, so I used page break so that it looks good. Here it is. So I use page break, so only title is here. Okay. And then contents in a separate page. After that, nothing. Page number 2. Then abstract. Then your actual main text starts. Okay. You can see some question mark here due to citation. I will come next how to cite a paper in your document. Okay. So up to this, the table of content, you can write a whole thesis using this. I can show you mine if you don't mind.
Okay. No, of course not. We would love to see your thesis.
Yeah, thank you. So here it is. So here is the title page. Then some element things and the acknowledgement. Here is the contents I wanted to show you. Okay. So it is beautiful, and I didn't put any extra effort to write this. You can see. And there are many more things. So after this table of contents, I wrote list of figures. That is also one single line command. you will see it will start in incoming. Once inline command, we will give you the list of figures in the beginning of the document. You don't need to put any extra effort because you already, the LaTeX already have information about all your figures, figure number, and these are the figure numbers, and also the captions of the figures. It will copy the caption, it will copy the figure number, and it will make a table for you. List. Okay, and here is the page number, corresponding page number. There is a list of figures. So, many such facilities are there in LaTeX. Okay. So, now I will go to the final thing, which is how to cite a paper using LaTeX. Okay. Bibliography and citation. So there are two ways. One is, this is the last thing, so I will take time because it is a bit tricky thing. So there is an easy way. So the easy way is surround the bibliography with begin bibliography. Begin, then the bibliography, and then 99. This is a dummy number. Okay. It will suggest the compiler that keep space for at least 99 references. Nothing else. If you have, say, 2 or 5 references, you can put them 9. And if you have more than 10 but lesser than 100, you can put this 99. That is not necessary. Just a thing. So you write this, I will recommend. And then end the bibliography at the end. And write down your bibliography or the references in between them, which will start with this command, bib item. Okay? So / bib item, then some label name. You already know what is label. So some label name, where label is some word for the references, and when you try to cite that particular bibliography, you just use this comment, okay, in the body of your text, just that cite the same label name, okay. The label name for each bibliography or each reference will be different. So I prefer how I write. I just write the first author's surname, then the journal name, then the year of the publication. Say Cates, TRL 2012. So this is a very good way to write the label name. Okay. So then cite with the same label name in your text what is written in a bib item. So let us see with an example. Okay. So do I have any thing I have? There is a whole paper. I will copy from that. Where is the end? Yeah. So you can see. Suppose I will copy the first two. Okay. I will copy. Have they copied? I copied here. My test document. Remember, you need to write the bibliography at the end, but before the end document, because the compiler will not read anything after any document, so I will paste it here. You can see. So now I need to end this thing. In the bibliography. Okay. So here is each bibliography will start / bib item, then a label. This is the label I use. Author name, some journal, and here. And this is the way to write in physical review journals. Okay. So see the first letter of your name, author's name, then surname, comma, again first letter, surname, so on, and then the name of the journal, and then okay, so then name of the journal, physical review letter in this form, then / bold font 93. This is the volume number of the journal, so 93 will appear as bold font as it is volume number, then page number of the journal, then space 2004, the year of publication. Okay, this is the way physical review journal accept the references. Now okay, let me first compile it and see what is the output. In practice, I was doing in practice, right? Yeah, you can see. Let me zoom in. You can see a line has been appeared automatically, a vertical line. That signifies the end of your main document, and after that, the citations will appear. Okay. Sorry, please hold on. Okay. Export. Yeah. So this is the first reference and the second reference. You can see it has been appeared as I wrote there. This volume number in bold, page number in ordinary, and then here, similarly this journal. Now I am going to refer this in the main text. Okay, the label. Let me copy the label. I have copied it. Now I want to say, I want to refer here. In section this, we have discussed about density spreading, but I want to refer some journal. I refer here. So / CIPE is very easy. Density bracket, then give the level name. To refer some equation or figure, use / refer, then second bracket, and to cite any reference paper or any document, just / cite CIT. And if you want to cite more than one thing, just give a comma and put another name, another label. Say this one. Okay. Now let me check, compile and check. So 1 and 2, yeah, you can see. So in section 1, we have discussed there the third bracket and 1, 2, and everything will be taken care of by the LaTeX compiler. We don't need to worry about that. in the references. Yeah. Okay. The next thing, so this is the easy way to refer. But the problem is when you change the paper. Okay. So suppose your paper is like me. So suppose your paper has been rejected from some journal and you need to submit it in another journal. Okay. So in that case, you need to change this orientation, right? Some journal like to have the title of the paper, say, here. So you need to write each of the title of the paper here. Or some different arrangement. So what we do, actually each journal has their
own. Shubhadeep, sorry to interrupt. Shubhadeep, are you there?
Yeah, I am here.
Please repeat, your voice broke and because just the last two lines.
Okay. So suppose your paper is rejected from one journal, you want to submit in another journal. So what you will do? Suppose the second journal prefers some different orientation of your references. Say they want the title of the paper in the reference. Okay, so you need to type all the titles 1, 2, 3, 4 in each thing. So there are some more modifications which they want. So to avoid those things, and another thing, suppose usually we work in same field, right? And we refer same paper again and again in different document. So it is easy to keep a list of all references in a documented way and refer them in an easy way. Okay, so I will discuss that now, how to do that. Okay, so presentation. Here it is. So the easy way, I think you understood that. And bibliography and citation, this is the robust way. So for this way, again, you need those packages I have already put in earlier tech files. No new thing, that only those packages execute this robust way. So make a bibliography file with .bib at the end. At the end is the wrong thing. So make a different file, bibliography file with .bib. How to do this? Just open a new file, blank file, as you open a tech file, and change the extension, so .bib. And I will show how a bibliography file will look like. And once you made a .bib file or a bibliography file, you just use / bibliography command and your file name. So if the file name of the bibliography file is file.bib, don't use that bib, only the file name here without the bib in your actual text. I will show you and it will be clear, don't worry, it is not that difficult. Okay, so the first step is make a bibliography file, separate file .bib. And the second step is use that bibliography file using this command, / bibliography file name. Okay, let me show you. I have made one. I will upload it, don't worry. So let me first show you the PDF, how does it look. So this is going to be your last assignment, final assignment for the LATIC course. So you have already done up to this equation 3. So the next part will be just to include any figure if you want, or my figure I have uploaded. Then this that messy thing, many equations are here. You can skip if you want. I mean, you can write some of them. And I will recommend to write this matrix thing. Okay? Equation 12 and 13. You should take help of array. You already know how to write an array. So, write these things. This thing will be an element of array, right? This is first element, second element, third element, and fourth element. So this will be element of array and product of a matrix. We just try it. Otherwise, I'll finally give the text file. Don't worry. Okay, this is your assignment, and you can see I have included six reference here. So the style of the reference has been taken automatically by the document class. I used RevTech4 document class for physical review journal. It took automatically. I didn't type these references. What I did, I made a bibliography file. I am going to show you. Okay, and they have been referred in several parts of your document. This is an extra new thing you should notice. So now we will cite some papers. So if you put 1, 2, 3, it will take 1, 2, 3 using an hyphen automatically. You don't need to do, just put a label name 1, label name 2, label name 3. Okay. Now how to create an bibliographic file? Let me show you. So I already have an bibliographic file. This one is my bibliography file. Name is runandtumble.bib. Runandtumble is the dummy name. You can put anything. Okay. So any name .bib. Let me open. I don't know. No, I can open in my laptop. But it should, I don't know how to open in your Windows. Okay, it should open a notepad, yeah, notepad or WordPad will be effective. So open in your notepad. I will open it, my gedit software. Okay, so this is how an a bibliography file look like. So it has all the details of the references. Okay, I want to refer in my paper. So all the references related to my work on some particular field of statistical physics, I used to use them repeatedly in my paper. So I made a bibliographic file, full list of. Here are a few of them. So this is a signature, this is an article type. Okay, if you want a thesis, you can write in this way, a PhD thesis. So you, if you can remember, you gave a name, a label. So this is the labeling, right? The surname, then journal name, then the year. That is my way to do. You can do it in your own way. Then title of the paper, author of the papers, journal, and everything, volume, issue, everything, everything, URL, DOI, everything. And finally, end it with a second backend. And the good thing is, you don't need to write these things. I will show you how to find all the details of these things from internet, okay? So, what is your question? Is there any software to make a bibliographic file? Okay, no, there is no software. You need to find yourself and I have written these things. This is for thesis, and all our article, rest of the thing are article. You can refer a book, or you can refer anything.
Shubhadi? Hello? Shubhadi, are you there? Shubhadi, I guess we lost the connection. Shubhadi, can you hear me? Okay, I guess we lost the connection again with the speaker. So please give me a few moments to connect him again.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, this time I can hear you.
Yeah, it started raining again. So sorry.
Okay.
So
it's like my webinar is dependent on the rain. Yeah.
Yeah, like if you can catch.
Okay, so please continue.
Yeah, I'm sharing my screen. Can you see me?
Yeah,
I mean, my screen.
I can see that your screen. Yes, your voice is little like it's breaking a little bit.
Oh, wait a minute.
Lost the screen again. Yeah, now.
Yeah.
Now it's fine. Yeah.
So, I'm typing. I'm searching for a paper. See.
Your voice is not audible. You are not audible, Shubhadeep.
Not audible?
Yeah, again, it's better. It's better. Yeah.
Better, right? Okay. Okay, okay. No problem. So, say I will go for this paper. Yeah, so you just go to a journal or particular paper, go to export citation, and there are different options. Say EndNote for the Microsoft Word, and this is BibTeX. You just copy this. Okay, just copy Ctrl C and paste in your bib file here, anywhere. Okay, so this is the way. Now change the label you want to label. So I want this in my way, Mojumdar. Physical review in, what is the year? 1996. Okay, so it is there. So I will save it. Now I want to refer this article. So I will copy this label. Okay. So I will just copy this label and go to my is it there? No, I should open another. So sorry.
We can't see the screen. Yeah, it's fine now.
Yes. It's fine? So should
yes,
I repeat?
We just saw you renaming the label and then we lost the visual.
Okay, so what I did, just I copied and pasted this BibTeX part and renamed the label, and I will copy this. And I will paste this in my where I want to refer. Okay, so suppose there is my take file. So take this one. I want to open with my editor. It is open here. You can see I have included the bibliography runandtumble, not bibliography runandtumble.bib. I removed the bib part here. Okay, only the name, not the extension. So it will take care of that, all the references, and I want to say refer. See here, Euler's equations. Okay, so slash in same way, slash C I T inside, then just paste the label Mojumdar TRE 1996 and compile it. Now let me check how the paper look like. I think not. Yeah. So I think Mojumdar. Yeah, this one, reference 5. You can see it came at reference 5 as I called the author references 1, 2, 3, 4 earlier. So it will arrange automatically according to your call. In one another facility. So you put in any order in your .bib file. See, I have put this in the second bibliography. This is the first, this is the second, and then my thesis hard. Okay, so it is second, it doesn't matter why you put them. It will arrange them in your actual PDF automatically as you call in your document. So you have cited 1, 2, 3, 4 earlier. That is why they came earlier. You can see. So I have put 1, 2, 3 here and 4 here. Then I have cited reference 5 here. Okay. Reference 5 here. So that is why it came at number 5. And if you change the document class according to your different journal here, it will take care of the arrangement of your references. You no need to worry to arrange them. Not only the appearance, numbering, also the way to represent that, say author name, full name or short name, title will be there or not. No need to worry about that. Very robust. Okay, any question? I am stopping.
May I ask you a question?
Sorry, you have questions?
Yeah, may I ask you one question?
Yes, you.
So, when you were showing the bibliography part, that writing the references.
Yeah.
So, when you were copying the bibliography details from any journal.
Yes.
We don't need to maintain any order while pasting it in the bib file.
No, you don't need to.
So the LaTeX will automatically renumber all the references and it will like give me the list at the end according to the numbering.
Yes. So suppose you have, I have a bibliography file, mother file. I have all the reference I need regarding our research. So I suppose for a particular paper I don't need, suppose I have 100 of references there in the .bib file. I need only 50. But those 50 are there. So I refer the name by their label name in the main document, okay, in that tech file. And so only those 50 in the reference list. In a PDF.
Okay. So it's like, see, if I have four references and I want to insert one more reference between two and three.
Yes.
So the new reference will be automatically numbered as reference number three, and the last two, which were previously numbered as three and four, will automatically be numbered as four and five. Is that right?
Exactly.
Okay, thank you.
So I have nothing to say. So what I want to say is what more can be done using LaTeX. So you see, I need to share my screen, right? Mm-hmm. That is Zoom. Oh, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
How can you hear me? I cannot see. Oh, yeah. Okay. I'm going to share my screen again. So, I will upload all the text. I mean, not now, because of the assignment. First, try yourself. Okay, I will upload the assignment 3 in the Google Classroom. Then you just try, and finally, after this, after 2 or 3 days, I will upload all the text files related to assignment 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And what else can be done? This is just as you can see, I have made this presentation in LaTeX. So you can make a presentation in LaTeX. I am not going to discuss it for shortage of time. So you can search in internet, you will find a template for presentation. You can find template for different journal also. You can find template for different articles, say and also for thesis. I use just one template available in internet. Okay, so there are lots of templates you want. And you can write anything. And even you can write a poster. A whole poster I have written in LaTeX. So there are many templates and many things can be done. So I have just explored the basic things. And you try yourself the rest of the things. And that is all. So I should stop now. And tomorrow I will. We have any doubt regarding this LaTeX, and then go to the GNUplot part. Okay, I hope you all have installed the GNUplot software. And anything else, Samantha?
Sir, I'm Dr. Vasudev. We have one more question from one of the participants. Yeah, over to you, Manjali.
Can we import any sort of file in this LaTeX?
Sorry?
Word file or Excel file? Can we import any sort of file in this document?
I mean, can we import any data from Excel or Word directly to LaTeX? Or are these two entirely different platforms and cannot be interconnected?
I think so, but I am not sure. I will not say anything about it because I don't know. I never did it. And you can try. I mean, you have to search. You also have to search. You have to search. I don't know.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Shumanti?
Yeah.
May I conclude?
So thank you again, Shubhadeep, for your wonderful lecture. I understand that it is not easy to incorporate this many stuffs of LaTeX within this short period, but I know you worked hard for designing the content. So I got really scared in the beginning about the internet connection, but eventually it worked out in our favor. Thanks to God for that.
Thank you.
So, tomorrow we have the session on GNUplot in the morning at 11 a.m.
Okay.
I have requested all the participants to get the installation done. I have shared the installation files also. I shall send a reminder email again today for the additional support. Just to remind our participants that we have only one lecture on GNU plot. So please get the GNU plot installed by today. And if you face any problem, let me know by today only. Please don't leave it for tomorrow. So we will provide the recordings and the feedbacks will be shared. And your assignments will be uploaded in the Google Classroom. Now, I would like to request our IQAC coordinator, Dr. Panchali Majumdar, to conclude the session. Over to you, Panchali Di, and thanks to all.
Thank you so much. The sessions are so informative, and the learners on our end have no problem in understanding your lecture. Yesterday, when we were practicing your lecture, this is so lucid and in a nice way that, like me, who can't do anything, she can also understand.
Yeah, thank you. I have learned many things during the preparation time. Yeah, thank you.
Sir, so I think all of we will send our assignments in time, including me also, because in this case, we all are learners. And in the learning process, nothing matters, only to learn. So, hope we will meet in the next day and we'll follow the steps as instructed by Shyamanti, because she is a nice person who guided us.
Thank you, Panchali Di.
Prachanda jalachi, Shyamanti ke. Thank you so much. Thank you. Shyamanti and Orpita has done a lot, and to the previous speaker also, who has extended her lecture in such a nice way. Thanks to all of you for your patience hearing. So, Shyamanti, please end the session for today.
Yes. Oh. So, we will end it here today. See you all tomorrow. Bye.
Okay. See you tomorrow.